veteran Conservative Party advisor, David Cameron's deputy chief of staff. He's been called Cameron's fixer, and he's had what one might call unparalleled access to power over a very long time, over the last four decades, right there in the heart.
Peter Wrighton, if it still exists, contains clear evidence.
Bill, are you there?
I'm here, Lou. I'm on the street though, so
that's all right. You know, Bill, we've only got 5-10 minutes. Okay, so congratulations on your work and getting it out by the mainstream media. Can you tell us a little bit about, I know you can't say too much for legal reasons and you don't want to bring any sort of harm to the guys who are exposing this, but can you just give the listeners here a brief rundown of what happened and how you got involved with this case of what's come out in the Daily on the Sunday Express yesterday?
I
know you can't say too much, I know, but if you can give us like the basics.
Yeah, it will be very basic as well. Morning, everyone. First of all, I would like to start by saying that we have an international paedophile ring that's been operating within every democratic government on our planet. There has also been connections to the Middle East, all over the world. We're looking at the killing of children. We're going back towards just a guy called Sidney Cook, which those that are initiated into this subject will understand. We're looking at the torture of children. We're looking at snuff movies. I'll tell you what happened. One snuff movie, our victim was forced to film a snuff movie, all by Sidney Cook. This is our witness, the main witness that has come to us, because he doesn't want to go too far now with the police and the secret services, if you like, that are involved. So, you know, this is a very precarious position. We're talking about, I'm not just talking about in this country, I'm talking about all over the world, every sovereign country, we're everywhere. And I've been working on it for 6 months now, Lou, and even me, it has rocked me.
Yeah.
It has rocked me to my foundations. I cannot believe the names that are coming out. And as you know, Lou, you know, I've been doing this kind of work for a very long time. So Leon Britton, you know, at witness, was attacked and raped by Leon Britton. Leon Britton is one that they don't want to go for at the moment. Our witness identified Leon Britton by a tattoo that he has on his groin. Our witness drew the tattoo for the police, etc., etc. But like I say, I can't say too much.
No.
But it is horrific, and we're talking about. I think I would just like to say, on a strong point towards the guy Robert Green.
Yeah.
Holly Gregg, the Down syndrome. We're talking about disabled children being ferried between all the Channel Islands, especially the Isle of Sark, the Isle of Wight, Jersey and Guernsey. We're talking about, I don't know if you can put it down as a religion, as a satanic religion. Is it a religion? You know, I'm not just... I can hear how I feel, Lou. You know,
I can hear in your voice, Bill. I mean, how's the victim doing? He's exposed all this. You were with him with Chris.
The victim is a very vulnerable person. He's also a very brave man for coming forward. He has a partner. He has a disabled partner that he is a carer to as well. He has suffered immensely himself. A child was killed in a bed next to him by Sidney Cook. Sidney Cook then went on to continue to use this victim that never died in that bed to perpetrate, if you like, and try to turn him into one of them.
Yeah.
Sidney Cook made him shoot a film, like I say, a snuff movie. When that was done, he said, "Now you're one of us." Sidney Cook would choke children in their beds, or wherever the film was being shot. And as the victim put it, he said to me, he said, he'd choke him, Bill, until he went blue. Then he would blow in his mouth again. So what Sidney Crook used to do, he used to strangle, choke the kids, then resuscitate them. So if you like, kill them, bring them back to life, kill them, bring them back to life. This went on, this one incident went on over 3 weeks. This was our witnesses, Andrew.
Andrew, what's his surname? Andrew, I haven't got his name in front of me. Andrew.
You haven't got the full name in the paper.
Oh, right.
I've not put his full the paper because, unfortunately, we're dealing with the national press and we had the means at the time in film footage. I was present at the whole interview and we were advising Andrew, and a couple of points. The interview became very heated. That's all I can say. Now,
are we going to start seeing arrests, Bill?
I certainly hope so. But what I can say is I have a list, and it is not the full list, of 35 people, politicians, the majority of the public would recognise. They would recognise, and we're not just talking about men now, we're talking about women, not dirty old men. We're talking about the trafficking of children. And if I can just go back to Holly Gregloo.
Yeah, sure.
A lot of these victims on, I can't say whose yacht it was, but I will tell you the particular story that I'm talking about, it was not Ted Heath's yacht, though the same was happening there. But on this particular yacht, was on it, and there was 3 or 4 normal kids on there, normal, if you like, up to between the ages of, say, 10 and 13. And then there were maybe 6 or 7 Down syndrome children. The normal kids, where they all had their trip, and then they were dropped off at Holland. But the Down syndrome kids were kept on. Now, everybody's got to remember that they didn't school these children purely with fear, Lou. A lot of them treated these kids really well. They put these kids into a sort of a fictitious adult world. They would let them smoke, they would let them swear, they would let them have a drink. And this particular woman done, can you hear me, Lou?
Yeah, I can hear you fine, Bill.
I would just like to tell everyone what this particular member of parliament done. I'll put it into the victim's own word. She grabbed hold of my head, Bill. She pulled me down to her C, vagina, but he said to her C, and said, come and suck on this, you. He said, and the stench was repellent. It was disgusting.
Oh my God,
that
Bill.
Was at a party. That was at a party. Sidney Cook, the child killer, was also at parties with Jimmy Savile and many other representatives of the entertainment industry, the political institutions, the legal institutions and the medical institutions, and it is horrendous.
I mean, Bill, I mean, I can see in your voice you sound exhausted by it all. We've only got a couple of minutes now, and I mean, I'll give you a call after the show.
We are making a film.
You are going to make a film, but what... Yeah, go on, sorry.
No, the film is being made, Lou. We are in the production of the film. I have all footage of the interview with the Daily Express as far as this case is concerned. And within that interview, there are other subjects talked about that have not been disclosed. But I must say, and I want to make this clear to everyone, that the alternative media is working with the national media. And it is not just Prime Mass Films. At the moment, I have a very small, tight team working on this, but the national media is working with the alternative media. And we are talking about kidnapping, murder, torture. Another young child, I want to put this one across, Lou. There was another young child, the snuff movie was made, that Andrew was present at. The kid was 12 years of age. They removed his genitalia with a scalpel. They moved all of the kids' genitalia with a scalpel and filmed him bleeding to death. It took 3 minutes for the kid to die. These films were commissioned for people, and they would pay between £20,000 and £30,000 per film. Then the film was supposed to be destroyed. Now, I don't want to say what operation it is, whether it's U3, whether it's Fernbridge, whatever it is, but this this is what is happening.
And the police...
And this, I would like to... I just want to emphasise, Lou, that this has is not a sexual thing. The killing and the making of snuff movies, the trafficking of children, the raping, the torture of disabled children. It is, like I say, I don't know what word to use. I just see it as a satanic religion.
It's just,
and,
there's something
what is happening in Parliament is disgusting.
So the police are fully aware of this. The police and MI5 and the security services have knowledge of what is going on, yeah?
100%, 110%, 1,000,000%, 2,000,000%.
Right.
They know what is going on, and it is as we've always thought that world politics, the national media, and the alternative media to a degree, is being controlled by paedophilia versus blackmail.
Jesus. And Bill, just closing, what do you, I'll phone you straight after the show in about 20 minutes, but what do you want to see happening now? What needs to be done now to sort this out? What do you want to happen after all this? After you've heard all this and you know the police have been involved, what do you want? What do you want to happen?
I don't want to die.